date now if you feel like dancing. Today is a good day to have a good old boogie because it's International Dance Day. Does anybody boogie anymore? Sarah England School of Dance in Staley Bridge organised a special flash mob routine. It took place online this morning. It ended up going global. Sarah's with me this afternoon. Hi, Sarah.
Hi, Phil. How are you doing?
Yeah, really good. Thank you. Does anybody boogie anymore? Is that okay?
I don't know. I like a bit of a boogie.
Oh, good. Right.
That's stuff going on.
Me and you, once isolation's over, we're out there. Tell us how this started.
Well, it was a few days before the schools closed, and we all knew it was coming. We all knew the lockdown was coming. And I was just sitting at home, and I thought, what am I going to do to keep my students engaged whilst they're all at home? And I thought of the song. The song was "We're All in This Together" from High School Musical.
Oh yeah.
And then I contacted my teachers, Katie and Faye, and they made up a dance on the first day that we were shut on the Saturday, and we planned to put it out to our students. But I'm part of a Facebook group online. That's a global Facebook group, and teachers were sharing the resources and being really kind and trying to help each other out during this time. And I just put it out there. Does anybody want to join us with this dance on International Dance Day? And 360 schools sent me their email addresses.
Oh, my goodness. By the way,
we're in 24 hours.
I'm a bit embarrassed about the fact I was so quick to acknowledge that I knew the High School Musical song, but let's move on from that. No need to dwell on that, thank you. What's been the experience then? Because that's an incredible audience, isn't it?
Yeah, it's been amazing. I think we've actually had 20 something schools join in today that I know of. I know that other schools have joined in because I've been getting messages. We've done it. We'll be posting later. So there's no way of knowing actually how many, but I'm guessing at least 1,000 of us have been dancing this dance today. And it's places in New Zealand, Australia, Malaysia, Guatemala, Colombia, all over the US.
Wow.
It's just been absolutely phenomenal. It's been a bit mind-blowing, and emotional is the word that's coming out of everybody's mouths today. You know, the parents have texted and said, it's been emotional to see, you know, to see all these posts from all these children that are in exactly the same situation as our own.
And of course, they'll all have had very different backdrops, wouldn't they? For instance, I know there were one or two dancing on the beach, weren't there?
Oh, yeah, that's the Turks and Caicos Islands. Yeah, so they had beautiful backdrops.
Yeah, not that we were envious in the slightest.
Not at all. At least we've got sunshine. So.
I can imagine this has caused you a few sleepless nights, hasn't it? Because to put all this together and to coordinate it and to ensure that it all happened technically even was quite a feat, wasn't it?
Now you mention it. It was a bit strange this morning. I did wake up this morning, and some mornings, especially at the moment, go quite slowly because there's not a lot of change. But this morning, the route from 6:30 this morning to 10 o'clock seemed to go really quickly. And I had an iPhone streaming live on Facebook and an iPad streaming live on Instagram at the same time. And then I had my laptop with Zoom class with everybody on it. And then something else playing the music. It was just a little bit hairy.
I love it though. Can we watch the dance back on Facebook and Instagram?
You can't. I've just posted. I've been editing all day. So we did it live. So you can see the live, what we did live this morning. And also I've edited things together from the Zoom class to try and get all the children on it and to thank all the schools that took part that I know of to post that as well. So that we've just literally in the last 20 minutes posted a full edited version of everybody dancing. So, yeah, I'm really, really grateful and really overwhelmed that the response has been so huge. And, you know, really grateful to my parents and the kids at my school to get behind it. It's just been amazing.
Give us the details, Sarah, so people can have a look. Where can you find you on Facebook and Instagram?
So the Instagram page set up for it is at GlobalFlashMob2020.
Global Flash Mob 2020. And what's it been like the last few weeks? Obviously, you know, with the School of Dance, you're like everybody else, you can't all get together. Have you been doing a lot of Zooms?
Yeah, a lot. Well, we did a lot of pre-recorded stuff. We're doing a little bit of Zoom classes because, you know, technically it's more difficult with internet and things like that. But yeah, we've done a lot of pre-recorded. And I've got to say, teaching 25 years, it's been a bit of a learning curve.
I can imagine. But what thing to achieve as well during, you know, they always got to look, you've always got to look out for the positives, don't you? And, you know, what incredible thing this is you've achieved.
Absolutely. I mean, the school really is to put a smile on everybody's face and to give everybody a love of dance. And if that's what we've done, and if that's what we've been able to do today, is make people smile whilst, you know, these are difficult times for everybody, then, you know, job done. Really happy.
Listen, I'm off to do the High School Musical. I'm flying, soaring. I'm going to join in later. Sarah, lovely to talk to you. Sarah England, who's from the School of Dance in Stalybridge.
BBC Radio Manchester.
Make a difference.